We have used annotations so far, like HTTP GET. This is one annotation. We used other annotations also, string, length. So those we were using for validators. Now we can learn the steps required for creating your own annotations, because every annotation is not available. And especially in the current project, I'll show you one problem, then we'll solve it by writing a custom annotation for that. First of all, let me take you to the problem. This is the current project. Let us run it. This is what we get. Click Edit. Change it to Software. I'm changing it to Software Order. Changing it to 100. Click on Save. It is correctly edited here. The problem is when you again click this Edit, you can see it is showing the older value. M Order 300. It is showing the older value. Now, does it mean that database was not updated? You can check that database was actually updated. How can we check that first? I close it, refresh it. It remains the same. This means database was correctly updated. It also means this was correctly updated. But the problem is a caching that is occurring on the server side. This problem you will notice when you use Internet Explorer. This problem will not be there when you use Chrome. Internet Explorer is caching the request. So when you call the same function on clicking edit, you're calling the same function AJAX edit, and the results are already cached, so it is returning you the information from the cache. As a result, even though database is updated correctly, this is also updated correctly, but the caching is causing this whole story to go wrong. Our objective is right now to prevent caching. For this, there is no annotation available. So we have to write our own annotation here. We'll see how to do that. This is our project. Click on the Solution Explorer, right click, first of all add a new folder, and I generally give it name utility so that it contains my utility classes. And here I'll add a class for my custom annotation. My attribute classes should end with attribute. So I'll right click, add class. I'm giving it the name no cache attribute and click add. My attribute will be called no cache and the class is no cache attribute. You must always suffix this attribute to the name of your annotation. I'll fold it backwards. All our attributes, they should inherit from a action filter attribute. This is the parent class.